I'll stay and walk this life with you, no matter what we may go through. Dead broke, no job, no house, no ride. I'm gonna stay right by your side. I wanna rock with you. With you and only you. I wanna rock with you. What's going on, YouTube? It's Kevin. Hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a good night. You know what? I had to break into that old Alicia Keys, because you know I was listening to their songs and they minor. And that album, that's my mother effing album. All Alicia Keys albums are my albums. And you know what's so crazy about her music is that I can remember where I was at a certain time in my life when I listened to her songs or whatever. So yes, shout out to Alicia Keys. Shout out to y'all for watching this video. Now for those that's gonna say, where's Mikel? Bitch, you knew Mikel wasn't in the video when you clicked on the image and you seen my face. When Jesus say yes, nobody can say no. See, I had to save myself because I didn't want to go off. Because I know how some of y'all get. Y'all like seeing me and Mikel together, but today is one of those days where we are not together. So if you don't want to watch, click off the video right now. Right now. I'm waiting. Click off. Anyway, since you're here and you decided to stay, click that thumbs up button and make sure that y'all share this video on Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, Instagram, or wherever you share our videos. If you're watching me, tag me on Instagram saying, hey bitch, I'm watching a video, I'm eating something and I'm watching you and stuff. I don't know how long this video is going to be. I don't know what the hell I'm going to talk about. Whatever you're asking me to talk about on Instagram, I'm going to try to talk about some of the topics if I know what the hell is going on, because today was a chill day for me. It was such a chill day for me, and you know, I found out that Mikel wasn't coming today because, you know, I was watching The View this morning, and Whoopi Goldberg, wait a minute, I do want to, yeah, I'm going to, Whoopi Goldberg pissed me the hell off, and, you know, I just wasn't feeling what she was saying, and they was just going in, like, The View was very heated tonight, and they weren't talking about politics. Did I say tonight, the heat
just flowing through your body, temperature is right.
Anyway, so yes, they was just going in, and I was like, bitch, Mikel, before you get to my house today or tonight, you need to watch The View, because I want you to see what's going on. So you're going to text me, bitch, I'm on my way to the Bill Cunningham show. I'm in New York. Well, I said, bitch, I'll see you on Monday. Because I knew he's not going to be here. And I know them shows, they tape for a little while. And then you got to deal with all that traffic getting back home. Who's to say he's coming back home? I know he wanted to spend his birthday in New York or whatever. So, no, you ain't got to rush back here to work. I know how to press that record button. So in the meantime, I was trying to find a co-host for the day. I tried Brandon. I can't right now. I tried Dennis. The bitch ain't never called me back. He never called me back. So then I was going to call my friend Eddie and see if he wanted to come over and do it. Then I was like, well, I don't know. He might got some stuff planned, so I just didn't do it. So I just said, shit, I'll just do the video by myself. So here, I'm here. I'm doing it solo. I'm by myself doing the video. So anyway, how many followers do you have on Instagram? Do you still have your correct number of followers? Because Instagram said bye girl, fly girl to about millions of accounts. They got rid of millions and millions of bitch, Instagram was warning y'all. I know I seen the warning. They was like, now Kevin, look, your follower count is going to change. It's going to change. So I'm like, okay, well, when the hell are they going to start deleting these accounts? So I woke up this morning, and I know I was inching closer towards 23,000 followers on Instagram. And if you don't follow me or Mikel, make sure you follow us. So then when I woke up, I had 20,800 something subscribers. So Instagram really got rid of those spam accounts. And a lot of those spam accounts, people buy them just to be relevant on Instagram. But I'd be like, bitch, how you got 12,000 followers and only 10 likes on a picture? Something in the water don't sound right. Bitch, I can post a picture of a black image and I could get like at least 20 something likes.
Probably no, I could get more than that. If I posted, you know what? I'm gonna find a white back. No, I'm not. But if I posted a white background, people are going to like it. So don't tell me you got 12,000 followers on Instagram for your little boutique store and only 10 likes. Like, it's just crazy that people want to buy followers just to be relevant, and you don't have to do that. Just work hard and be yourself, and then the followers will come. Then you got the people that do tags for likes, likes for tags. You follow me, I follow you back. I let that go a long time ago. Like, when Twitter first came out, everybody used to do that, follow me back, follow me back. Now I follow who the fuck I want to follow, and you don't have to follow me back. Or sometimes I unfollow you, and sometimes you unfollow me, and I still follow you. It is what it is. And by the way, shout out to those that's my friends on Xbox Live. If you are not my friend on Xbox Live, follow me. KEVSKORP1984. Maybe we could play some games together. I got that Sunset Overdrive. I got WWE 2K15. I got FIFA 15. I got that Killer Instinct. Yeah, I got a bunch of games, so just follow me, shit. Follow me on Xbox Live, maybe we can play some games together. But I don't know about this weekend, because I gotta start putting all of our videos together from the year and, you know, do the best moments and all that stuff. So yeah, shout out to y'all, and shout out to everybody on Instagram that wrote me, you know, because I want, you know, I haven't done this in about maybe 2 years. Well, I say, you know what, tell me what y'all want for the Scorpion Show for next year. Just tell me. And we got about 175 people to leave a comment saying what they want. And I said, you know, don't be rude with your criticism. And I'm loving the feedback. The feedback was great. Thank you so much. And as I get time over the weekend, I will go over that and, you know, pick out the good stuff, leave out the stuff I still don't like. And, you know, we'll move forward. But you know what? It all goes hand in hand. If you want all of these changes to the show, well, you know, you want some critique. Not critiques. You want to do some tweaks. It's also time for y'all to start giving back to our show too. Like, a lot of y'all don't like, a lot of y'all don't share, and y'all don't retweet. So it got to go hand in hand. So if you want us to, you know, do our part as a viewer, I would like for you to do your part too and share. Because again, people don't share. Now if I took the videos off the phones and stuff, then I'd be wrong. So if you still want to watch them on your phone, you can still click the like button. Stuff. So it all gotta go hand in hand with us and the viewers. So shout out to y'all for still watching. Hey, by the way, did I mention I'm by myself and that I tried to get two co-hosts and I couldn't? And I told Mikel not to come today because I knew he was gonna be in New York and I knew he was gonna get here in time. So yeah. Anyway, so today I was watching The View this morning. I watched The View and The View was off the chain. So Michelle Obama and Barack Obama, excuse me, President Obama, they shared their experience. I don't know who they shared it with. I don't know if it was for an interview or a book or something. But they shared, you know, that they still, you know, receive racial profiling, or, you know, they still, you know, still deal with racism even though they're in the White House. Like, somebody thought that Barack Obama was a butler, and somebody thought that he was a valet, excuse me, President Obama, and that Michelle Obama, she got mistaken as a worker in Target. I don't know how the hell you do that. And it led to the topic of discussion at the table of, is there still racism? Not is there still racism. Is America still racist? And you know what? Hell fucking yes, America is still racist. Whoopi Goldberg got up there and she said, to me, it was a lot of stuff that just didn't make sense. And then again, I got to remember that Whoopi Goldberg grew up in a different times. But if she's going to be on the show like The View, yes, it's okay to have your view. But in 2014, you have to get with the times and you have to know what's going on. So it was basically, it was Rosie O'Donnell, Rosie Perez, Laverne Cox versus Whoopi Goldberg. And Whoopi was trying to say that, let's say for instance, right, I walk in the store and a white person walk in the store together. They're not going to follow the white person. They're going to follow me. That's like an internal racist thing to do, to just start following a black person, assuming that he doesn't have money, assuming that he's coming into the store to steal. And she's saying that that's not racism, that's ignorance. It's both. It's racism and it's ignorance. To be following someone because the color of their skin, because you assume that they're going to steal or they don't have enough money to buy what's in the store. You don't know what the fuck is in anybody's bank account or what's on their credit limit. You don't know that, so you shouldn't be judging nobody. So Rosie Perez brought up a good one. She was saying how she was staying in some hotel in Texas. They had a VIP area, a nice hotel and everything. And they mistook her sister as a worker in the hotel. That was a racist stereotype. Because now they're saying that, oh, Mexicans are, you know, not only do they work in farms, you know, they work in the hotel. So now, because you're Mexican, well, she's Puerto Rican, but because you're Hispanic, oh, I hope I got it right, or because you're Spanish, or because you're Puerto Rican, you work in this hotel and we need you to clean that table. Or, bitch, I don't work here. I'm here with my sister. And Whoopi said, that's not racist. And I'm saying, oh, my God. So then Nicole, I got to play what Nicole said, because, you know, I got a lot to say about that, too. Like, Nicole, you really try to change it around, but you know what? No. You work for the White House, and maybe this is how y'all think, but this is not what it is. So listen.
Do you all think that we live in a racist country?
Without a doubt.
Absolutely. Okay, I think a country that elects an African-American president twice, I don't think every American is racist.
So basically what she's saying is that America can't be that racist because we elected President Obama 2 times. And then Rosie O'Donnell said, well, you have a Congress who doesn't allow him to do anything. And to say that, oh, because, you know, of course, black people, we are not the majority in America. But just because you had President Obama elected twice doesn't mean that there isn't any racist in America and that racism is over. Where the fuck, what rock are you under? That's just like saying, oh, because gay marriage is legal in more states than, you know, I mean, in more states than, how can I say, because gay marriage is legal in a lot of states in the United States of America, does that mean that, you know, people don't stereotype against or have feel some type of way against gays? Like, that's what I got from that. And hell fucking no, that doesn't mean that we've moved on as a country. No, I think that our country has become more tolerable, but you know, when a lot of people go home at night or when they sit behind their computer screen, they spew a lot of racist shit because they can't say it to no one's face or someone of color's face. They're not gonna do that. You can't do that, and you can't do that with me. Don't think you're gonna be in my face and then still talk that racist shit. No, it's not gonna work. It's not gonna work. And I'm not just talking about nigger. You know what? I've never been called that to my face. I don't know how I would react to it, but I think I probably would go off. Cause you're not gonna disrespect me just because I'm black and you don't fucking know me. And you know, that's the main problem. And it's not just with black people, it's with Latino people, and it's with Asian people too. We all experience racism at some point. I don't know about white people because they are the majority. And I don't know anybody hating on a white person because they're white. I've never hated a race because the color of their skin. I've never hated a race for that. And it's just so bad that people do that. It's terrible that people do that. You prejudge people because they're black or because they're Latino or because they're Asian. You prejudge them. And who the fuck are you to do that? Just because you are the majority, that doesn't mean that you are superior. You may think it, but that doesn't mean that you are. And then Whoopi goes on to tell Rosie that you don't know what it's like. No, she said, you don't know what it is a real racist. A real racist is someone that says, nigga, I hope you die to your face. That is not just racism, Whoopi. Racism goes on, and you're in the entertainment industry and you should know better. We can't even get movies made or greenlit because you think that, oh, no white person is going to see that. What do you call that? That's racist. Just because you think that one particular race might not go, that doesn't mean that everybody won't go out and see that movie. And then you're going to say, you don't know what it's like. What, let me go to the video, because I got to get the word for word on what she told Rosie O'Donnell. She going to tell her, you don't know. So Rosie told her, you don't have to be black to know what racism is. So Whoopi Goldberg said, oh, yes, you do. Yes, you do. You do not have to be black to understand what racism is. Again, you could be Latino and experience racism. You could be Asian and experience racism. People, we go through a lot, okay? Now, a white person can understand racism. They know it's wrong, and they still, some still do it anyway. They'll say stuff, they'll do stuff behind your back, they'll do stuff to your face, they'll say shit on the computer. It's everywhere. Racism is everywhere. And just because you say you have to be black to understand racism, that's wrong. You have to be black, or you have to be Asian, or you have to be Latino to understand the stereotypes, to understand how people prejudge you, or, you know, say all kinds of mean stuff about you or about your race. You know, it's, you, I understand, sorry, I'm going off because I'm just so mad. I do know one thing. A white person doesn't know what it feels like to experience racism. I do know that. So she can sympathize, but she can't feel how we feel. She wouldn't be able to, Rosie wouldn't be able to have that effect of someone calling her and say, you nigger. She doesn't know what it feels like to be called that, but she can sympathize with someone that has been called that. So don't say you don't understand what racism is because you are not black. That's not true. And as Rosie tried to tell her, I'm raising a black child. And you know Rosie O'Donnell done, she done adopt so many children and stuff. So you mean to tell me that when she sends her black child to school, that her child hasn't experienced no racism, and he comes home to tell her what might have happened or what might have been said for her to understand? And you know what? What would make our country better is if racism wasn't taught to the children. If it wasn't taught, it wouldn't be thought about. Because when you put white children and Latino children and Asian children and, you know, all the children together, they're going to do nothing but play. They're not going to have this thought, oh, I'm not going to play with you because you're black. Or I'm not going to play with you because your eyes are slanted. Or I'm not going to play with you because you're Mexican. Like, nobody thinks like that. It's all taught. It's all taught. And as you get older, you have the choice to still spew that nasty-ass hate or look at people and love them for who they are and not by the color of their skin. And yes, we still live in a racist world, and it's never going to change. It's never going to change. People are always going to stereotype. People are always going to say racist things. People are going to be taught to hate people because of the color of their skin or because where they're from. It's always going to happen, and it's never going to change. Would I like for it to change? Yes. Will it change? No. It's always going to be around. And then, you know, when I grew up, we have been taught that white people don't care about you. White people will stab you in the back. They're smiling in your face, stab you in the back. They just don't care about you. They'll pretend to care about you, but they really don't care. It's about their race. And you have to kiss their ass, and you have to do this, and you have to do that. Like, you hear it from teachers. You hear it from your parents. You hear it from your neighbors. You hear it from everybody. And then as I got older, I got a choice to pick out what I wanted to keep with me. And I don't judge anybody for the color of their skin, but I do watch my motherfucking back. I do tell you that. I do watch my back. And that's for anybody, because you can't trust nobody. But anyway, y'all, I'm just going off. And I really feel some kind of way about seeing Whoopi Goldberg go off today. I just think that she's so set in her ways that she didn't want to see it. It's like some people do have that internal racism, or that's the
the stereotype. Oh, because he's black, he don't have any money. He can't shop in here. Why is he here? Oh, he's going to steal. Let me follow him around the store until he buys something. That's not right to do that to anybody. It's not right.
So, I don't know what the fuck Whoopi Goldberg was on, but she's been on some other shit lately. So,
yes.
Whoo. Let me get some water right quick. Got me going the fuck all like this for 40 days and 89 nights. So Nicki Minaj and Kim Michelle, y'all know they got new albums out. Shout out to Kim Michelle, number one R&B album, 87,000 copies sold. She was saying that she wants to be the Black Taylor Swift. Now see, why can't Kim Michelle be Kim motherfucking Michelle that sings about relationships or its problems that she's going through in her life and put in her music? Don't compare that shit to Taylor Swift, because you are not Taylor Swift. You have already, like, created a lane for yourself because you sing about what you go through. Kind of like how what Mary J. Blige did. But you put out your own lane and you did music that people wasn't doing. You cursing, saying your coochie don't work and all of this stuff. You put all of that shit in your music. Like, nobody out is doing what you do. Maybe that's why some people feel threatened by you. I don't know. But you do what you want to do and you make the music that you want to make. So I don't want to hear, I'm the Black Taylor Swift. I don't want to hear that shit. No. You are K. Michelle, who have carved a lane out for herself in this tough-ass music world. And you're fucking doing it. And congratulations to you. And you keep being yourself. And that's what I like. So, you know, she was talking about her and Idris Elba and how they've recently been in communication. And he's not really feeling how Kim Michelle talked about their relationship on her new album. But as she said, this is my art. This is my work. Music is an expression. And I love it because it's some real shit that she's experienced and that she wrote about. And she's writing her music. So shout out to Kim Michelle for that. And Idris, you know, the best thing I can tell you is don't deal with anyone that writes or sing music if you don't want to be written about. I understand it's a privacy thing, but I love how people are able to express their feelings through their music, and especially when it's something real. And that album is so great. And the greatest music comes from a lot of pain. I don't know if y'all realize that, but it's the truth. So, you know, K. Michelle, keep doing your thing. And I felt bad for Nicki Minaj, and not because of her album sale projection. I have something to say about that. But I do feel bad for her because she was saying how she's been in a relationship with Safari. She was in a relationship with him for a long ass time. Like, even before she was famous. And it's tough being without him, and she's famous now. And she made a lot of decisions, including him. And it's hard not to have him around to get his input on what's going on. And I felt Nicki Minaj on that. And I just love how honest she was with saying that, and saying that she still loves him. And at times, she misses him. And she wouldn't be real if she would have said, no, I don't miss that bitch, or anything like that. So I'm glad that she kept it real. And I didn't listen to the interview, but I read about it. And a lot of people wanted my opinion on it. So that's my opinion on it. You know, just be real. As an artist, people appreciate you when you are real and not when you are fake or saying shit that your publicist told you to say. Just keep it 100, because that's what people want. People want honesty, and people want you to be honest, and people want you to be real with them. When they buy the music, they want to fit. First of all, they already want to know too much about you. So being to listen to the music, you know, they get to know more about you. Just like some of y'all hate when we whisper. It's not that you hate that we whisper. You're mad because you're not down with what's going on with what we're saying. Or it's not being told to you from our personal lives. That's why you get upset. So if someone made an album and just was not saying what they really wanted to say, you would be frustrated too. You're like, what the fuck are you talking about? What are you singing about? I don't know what you're talking about. So, because you're mad. It is what it is. But shout out to them. But you know what? I'm disappointed with Nicki Minaj's album sales. And don't blame me, because I'm not no... Bitch, what Nicki call her fans? The Barbs. I'm not one of the Barbs. people cursed me out because I said I wasn't going to buy the album. Somebody cursed me out and said, bitch, you going to buy that fat ass D'Angelo. First of all, do you know who D'Angelo is? For you to sit here to talk about him like that, I know you are a child. I know you are a child. Then you sit there and talk about somebody like that. But anyway, D'Angelo go way back. And his album was number 2 on iTunes. And is still selling. And that's with no promotion or no hit single. And it's number 2 on iTunes. So you think about that the next time you want to call somebody washed up and fat, bitch. So anyway, it's just... They're saying that she's going to sell around maybe 150,000 to 170,000. I do hope that she sells more than that. And it's kind of disappointing that our Barbs ain't supporting her like I thought they would. But one thing... Oh my God, this mucus. Sorry. But one thing I can say that I'm happy about Nicki Minaj is that bitch is on every fucking show. Watch What Happens Live, The View, The Real, I think it was Jimmy Fallon. She's doing a night show circus. Like, she's everywhere. She's everywhere. And that's what you do when you promote an album. So shout out to Nicki. And I'm just so sad that, you know, sad to hear that her album sales are not that high. This is going to be her lowest first week numbers for an album. And it's not okay. Because she has, millions of followers. But then again, that don't mean they real. Anyway, bitch, Instagram gave y'all the boot, bitch. The motherfucking boot. So, what else has been going on this week? Some stuff I'm going to save for Mikel. Sorority sisters, yes! And this is going to be my last topic, I think. No, this is not going to be my last topic. Is it going to be my last topic? Yes, it's going to be my last topic. Is it? Yeah, it's going to be my last. Yeah, it's going to be my last topic. So, Sorority Sisters, I had a chance to watch the show on demand. Now, a lot of the a lot of the sororities were upset with VH1 for airing a show like this because this show, Sorority Sisters, does not represent what a true soror really is or what sororities are all about. And that putting a show like this on TV is trashing their organizations. So, you know, a lot of people took to Twitter, took to Facebook, and wrote organizations, they wrote advertisement companies such as CarMax, Honda. They wrote to a lot of the advertisers that put their advertisements on the show and was saying, don't put your ads on this. And a lot of them responded saying, we won't put our advertising dollars towards this show because we don't want to disrespect people. You know, we don't want to disrespect y'all. And I'm saying, this is my thing. So, the main ones writing these organizations and bitching and complaining about this show are the same ones sitting up there watching Bad Girls Club, watching all the Love and Hip Hop franchises, and all the other nasty, trashy reality shows. But now, because they have a show that says sorority on it, and you got girls that represent all the different sororities, oh, now everybody wants to bitch and complain and say, oh, it's not representing us in the right positive light. But none of them shows represent us in a positive light. And the shows that do represent us in the positive light, you don't want to watch. Nobody wants to motherfucking watch. Nobody. Oh, it's boring. It's boring. See, you want the drama, and that's what we thrive off of. We all thrive off drama, even though we act like we don't. Bitch, we do. We all thrive off the drama, but we just don't want it at our door. That's the truth. But see, I was Facebooking with a female that was a part of our sorority. And I understood everything that she was saying. And, you know, she told me, she said, you know what? But if you think about it, we are, with this movement here, it's a start. It's a start to get all these other shows on TV, which I don't think they're ever going to get on TV. I don't even know if Sorority Sisters is going to be taken on TV. And you know what? I watched the show, and I must say that I was entertained by the show. It's petty drama like all the other motherfucking shows, but I liked it. The girls fighting at the fucking boutiques. All because you're part of that sorority. It's fucking stupid, but I was entertained. I didn't see nobody talk about the girl. I think she was a Delta or AKA, and she was poor. Not poor, but she's struggling, and her child is at home with her mother, and she was struggling, and another girl was just crying about trying to be accepted and things like that. So, no, it's not showing the core values of your organization, but you got to remember that people that go through a lot of things in life and act certain ways and do certain things, and they're all still a part of that, sorority. You got people from all walks of life in the sorority. And don't tell me that everything is all girl power, sisterhood, and you still got your ratchets, you still got your petty ones, and these are the girls that represent the ones you don't want on TV. And I know it sounds bad that I'm saying it, but I was entertained. I think that maybe they should change the name of the show if you don't want it to be... No, you can't change the name of the show. The only thing you could do is just get the show canceled if you really don't want it on TV. But I'm going to watch it because I was entertained. And I understand people. But you know what? If you want to pick one, you got to pick them all. You got to pick them all because all black people are not showing the positive light on them loving hip-hop shows. And, all hip-hop artists don't represent how the hip-hop artists are that's on Loving Hip-Hop. And that's not what goes on in every hip-hop artist's love relationship. That you see all that trash and all that trash. But then again, some of it do go a part of the culture. So I don't know. But I like sorority sisters, and I just was mad that you had a lot of people going off because they say, oh, this doesn't represent us, when we got a lot of shows on TV that don't represent us as a race or a culture, right? And we still sit there and watch it every Monday night at 8 o'clock and go off about it on Tuesday. And then you watch me on Wednesday or whatever day I post a video to talk about what happened. And you thrive off of it. But now, oh, it's a fraternity. Oh, no. Shit, they even got preachers on TV. Every preacher, they say, oh, this is not all what preachers do. This doesn't all represent us as preachers. Let's get this show canceled. No. So anyway, that's just how I feel about it. You knock one, you gotta knock all if they don't represent you in the best positive light. So that's all I have to say. Thank y'all for watching. I hope you guys have a great weekend. Oh, I know some people won't go off about me with my thoughts about the sorority life. Maybe because I'm not in a fraternity or sorority and I don't really understand all of that, but it is what it is. And preaching has been going on way longer than fraternities and sororities. So let me get out of here. Y'all have a safe weekend. Y'all be blessed and safe and all of that good stuff. See you next week. Peace.